Hey everyone, today I wanted to show you how you could take an iPhone, back up all the information in that iPhone, and then use a new iPhone to restore all the information from your old phone. So if you're upgrading from one phone to another, this is the right video for you. So let's jump into the old phone, let's go ahead and back it up, and then I'll go to the new phone and show you how to restore that backup. So we're here on the old phone and we want to make sure we have a latest backup on iCloud. This phone was actually plugged into iTunes and backed up to a computer, but we want to do it on iCloud. That was just for safety. So let's jump into settings here, and under settings we want to go down and find iCloud. Now this is a previous iOS, so iCloud is down here. In the new iOS it's right on top. So in this case, let's scroll down to iCloud and we want to go to backup here in the middle of the page, and we want to make sure iCloud backup is turned on and we want to back up. So in this case it says this iPhone cannot be backed up with iCloud because there is not enough iCloud storage. So if you see a message like this where it says your phone cannot back up because there's not enough space, you have a couple options. You could upgrade and get more iCloud space, or you could use iTunes by just plugging your phone and using your computer as a backup source. In this case, I want to upgrade because this is going to be a problem all the time if you don't have a bigger iCloud plan, and it's only 99 cents a month right now. So I'm going to click learn more, and down here it says buy more iCloud storage. I'm going to click that, and I want to say upgrade your iOS device, and this is how you upgrade. You go to setting iCloud storage and you buy more there. So let's jump into settings again. Go to settings. Go to storage, buy more storage. And we have the 5 gig free plan. We want the 50 gig for 99 cents a month. Let's click that and we press buy. All right, now the purchase is complete and we could use iCloud to back up our phone. Again, if you don't want to spend any money, iTunes is your other option, or you could make sure you don't have more than 5 gigs on your phone, which is unlikely. So I recommend doing this if you could afford the 99 cents a month. Let's press okay. Now let's go back to iCloud backup here. And we also needed to make sure we're connected to Wi-Fi. So now the backup now option is available. So I'm gonna go ahead and press that. This could take a little bit of time, so I'm gonna let this go. But depending on the size of your files, this could take up to half hour or even more. I'll let this finish and I'll get back to the process. Okay, so the backup is complete on the old iPhone. So if you look here, it says latest backup and it has the time of day. So if you have the latest backup with the time of today, that means it was successful. If not, go ahead and try to back up again to make sure you're successful here. And I'm gonna jump into the brand new phone here and go through the process. So once you jump into the phone, you should see this page and you have to go through these few steps. So select the language that you want, select your location, and then I'm just going to say set up manually down here. And on this page you should have seen a Wi-Fi page. I already signed into my Wi-Fi previously, but go ahead and sign into your Wi-Fi, and then you could either set up Touch ID now or set up later. In iPhone X you might have to set up facial recognition. I'll just do set up later for now, and I could go ahead and create a passcode here. And these are the three options you have now. You could restore from iCloud backup, from an iTunes backup, or you could set up as a new phone, or you can move from an Android. In this case, I'm gonna set up from my restore from my iCloud backup. That's how I backed up my old phone. I'll go ahead and set up to my iCloud and press next. So it gave me a verification code. It popped up in my old phone actually to verify. After that, this page comes up. I'm just gonna agree to terms. Okay, after a few minutes, you should get a page that says choose backup. So you have today's backup and you have any previous backup. You could say show all backups. But in this case, I want the latest backup, which is the one I just did in the beginning of the video. So I'm gonna press that. I'm gonna press continue here. I'm gonna set up wallet later, so I'll just skip this step for now. And I'm gonna set up Siri later. And I'm gonna press don't share. And you could either share or don't share. I'm gonna choose my view here. Standard is fine, I'm gonna press next. And now this is gonna take a few minutes to restore from the iCloud backup. So in this case, we backed up about 10 gigs on the previous phone. So this is gonna take a little bit of time and I'll come back when it's all done. Okay, looks like the backup is complete and the phone is gonna restart itself. The backup only took a few minutes in this case, and this screen is gonna take a couple of seconds just to get the backup to complete itself. Okay, it's asking me to type in my passcode. Again, I'm gonna change this passcode later, so it's just simple for this video. Restore complete, I'm gonna press continue. And it says it may take a few minutes to set up your Apple ID, so I'm just gonna let this play out. And there we go, it says welcome to your iPhone. So I'm gonna say get started. And it looks like all my apps are here and they're slowly starting to download. So you see it says waiting, but each of them are gonna start coming in. The messages are here and everything else has been backed up successfully. So one last step is on the old iPhone, I need to remove the SIM card and put it in the new phone that I got from someone else. Now, if you set this up at the store, you don't have to do this process, but since I'm just taking an iPhone from someone else, I need to take my old SIM card and put it in the new iPhone, which also has a used SIM card. So I'll use this pin here, but you could use a paper clip, or there are things called a SIM card remover that you could buy for a few bucks on Amazon. I just had this handy. All you gotta do is put it in this hole here, press down, and the SIM card tray should just pop up just like that. And then you could just grab it and then remove the SIM card. And you'll take this SIM card and put it in the new iPhone. Okay, this is the new phone. I put in the SIM card and I'm just gonna slide it in. Again, I turned off the phone when I did this process. So next is I need to turn on the phone to make sure everything is working correctly. Okay, now as you can see up here, we have AT&T and we have full service. So let me just go ahead and make a test call to make sure everything is working and everything is working right. So I'm gonna turn this off. And that's how you set up a new iPhone from a backup from an old iPhone. I hope you found this useful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for a lot more tech tutorials just like this one. And I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.